Hi, welcome to the first of a new series I'm doing called Songs for Sunday, or if you like, Songs for the Sabbath, the Day of Rest, Songs of Worship. And what I'm doing is taking songs from my old congregation, St. Peter's, which had, we had about four praise bands. We were a church that sang a cappella psalms only, and then we moved on to doing a cappella psalms, traditional hymns and contemporary songs. And this series is going to feature all of those. I have to say, sometimes you don't know what you've got until you leave it. Although I did know. I knew that our praise, our sung praise, was, for me, quite extraordinary often. It lifted me, it encouraged me, it helped me to preach. I know that there are some people who think, well, this is kind of like the preliminaries, the sermon's the main thing. But actually, we pray the word, we preach the word, we sing the word, and I listen to the St. Pete stuff. There's some of it on YouTube, and that's what I'm putting on here for a wider audience. And it just thrills me. And this song, I stand amazed in the presence of Jesus the Nazarene. Well, what I'm going to do with each of these is say something about them, and then we're just going to play the thing for you. It is an older hymn by Charles Gabriel. Gabriel was late 19th, early 20th century. I think he wrote around between 7,000 and 8,000 songs. He's an American from Iowa, learned music by playing the reed organ in his home. He worked with Grace Episcopal Methodist Church in San Francisco. This song first appeared in 1905, so it's just over 100 years old. I stand amazed in the presence of Jesus the Nazarene and wonder how he could love me, a sinner, condemned, unclean. How marvelous, how wonderful. And so many times I've stood and felt that, felt I'm in the presence of Jesus. How could he love me? How could he love me? Now, the second verse, for me it was in the garden, he prayed, not my will but thine. He had no tears for his own grief, but sweat drops of blood for mine. I know a couple of people who've objected to say, no, what do you mean he had no tears for his own grief, but sweat drops of blood for mine? Well, he did sweat drops of blood for mine. That's the point. Christ was in perfect blessed happiness in heaven. He came down to earth and he became the man of sorrows. They were not his sorrows, except insofar as he took our sorrows upon himself. And that scene in the Garden of Gethsemane, where Jesus, being faced with the burden of carrying our sins, cries out to the Father, take this cup from me, is something that indicates to us the depth of our own sin. And yet, when we're aware of the depth of our sin, I think it's incredible that he took it. He's taken it all. He sweat drops of blood for mine. You know, this isn't just a happy song. This is a profoundly theological song. It's a great song. It's a great song for us to begin. Stand amazed in the presence of Jesus the Nazarene. And again, you're not a Christian, you're unclean. You can be clean. You are a Christian, you feel unclean, but you've been cleansed by Christ. So I'll leave you with the cathedral bells, and I'll leave you with the St. Pete's guys and girls singing, I stand amazed in the presence. God bless you, this Lord's Day. Bye.
Shall ever be. How Is fine.